Hey guys, this is Trainer Dino here, and once again I'm back, and this time I don't have a new story, but I have a continuation of my original story, and that is what if Paul challenged the battle frontier. But before that, I want you to meet my friends Haunter and Gengar. I have a feeling that you would be seeing one of them in the story. So without further ado, let's begin. Part 4, what if Paul challenged the battle frontier. In the last part, we saw Paul defeat who did it in Noland in his first frontier battle. And there he used Combusken, Weavile and Rapion. But this time we will dwell deeper into the story of Gastly. So without further ado, let's begin. Part 4 of what if Paul challenged the battle frontier. Paul was in Cerulean City training with his Gastly and Combusken as they were trying to reach a new level. The battle was intense as Gastly was finally starting to get into the hang of the high level training that Paul imparts on his Pokemon. Unlike his Chimchar, Gastly and Combusken were quite comfortable with the rigorous and rough style of training that Paul likes to do. So the two of them fit his personality quite perfectly. As they trained together, they were approached by a trainer. He introduced himself as Harrison, as he was intrigued to see Paul's Combusken and tells him that this reminded him of his own Combusken. Paul asks him if he has a Combusken, and Harrison tells him that he used to, as he sends out his Blaziken, adding that it evolved long time ago and Blaziken is his starter Pokemon. Paul is intrigued by this and asks Harrison for a battle. Harrison of course accepts as they start off with their Combusken and Blaziken respectively. Although the result is quite obvious, Combusken manages to put up quite a good fight as it manages to connect match Blaziken's place kick, divert his sky uppercut with its own double kick, and also clash flamethrower and fire spin attacks. Although Blaziken wins, Harrison tells Paul that his Combusken is way more powerful than what his own Combusken used to be a long time ago. Paul thanks him as he asks that if it was a one-on-one battle, and Harrison tells him that he was hoping to test out his new Pokemon against a trainer, and Paul seems like a perfect high-level trainer to do so. Paul gladly accepts as the second battle begins. Here, Paul sends out his Gastly as Harrison sends out his Nidorino. Nidorino is unable to catch up with Gastly's speed and ghostly moments as Gastly connects with Smog and Nightshade repeatedly. Ultimately, it dodges a drill run from Nidorino because its limited ability and is able to connect with another Nightshade, which knocks Nidorino out. Paul and Harrison shake hands after a great battle and promise to battle each other down the road again. Harrison, as a tip for Paul, tells him that he should try and enter the Cerulean Cave to train there, as it had abundance of strong Pokemon, and he may find one for his own team. Paul accepts this as he departs for Cerulean Cave. On the outskirts of the cave, Paul could sense something odd going on. Gastly becomes increasingly agitated as he spots something. They both go to the entrance of the cave and they find Kadabra. One of the locals nearby tells him that this Kadabra recently emerged from the depths of the cave and is causing havoc to the outsiders. Paul thinks that this is a perfect time as he scans Kadabra in his Pokédex and finds it to be at a really high level. This would be a great addition to his team, as Harrison suggested. Paul sends out Gastly once again as it squares off with Kadabra. Kadabra smirks at Gastly, almost egging him to come on. The battle begins as Gastly starts off with Nightshade. However, Kadabra instantly uses teleports and appears behind Gastly. After that, it uses a powerful Psy Shock attack, which sends Gastly crashing into the rock and then to the water. Gastly tries to get up, but Kadabra uses another Psy Shock which knocks him out for good. Paul recalls Gastly and decides that he should send out Kambusken next. However, Gastly refuses to go into his Pokeball and runs off disappointed. Kadabra starts to laugh as he goes back into the cave once again. Although normally Paul would leave Gastly be here, he of course has a change of heart after the Sinnoh, of course, as he pursues Gastly. He is unable to find Gastly as it turns dark. Paul decides that he needs to be innovative for once, as he goes to the Pokemon Center and requests Professor Oak for a special Pokemon of his to be sent over. This, of course, is another ghost type, Froslass. They are able to track Gastly in the nearby wood in the middle of the night. Gastly is training by itself, trying to master its new move, Shadow Ball, which it learned after running off and training. Paul is able to relate to Gastly as it remembers his own crushing defeat to Brandon in his last battle. Paul tells Gastly that he is not in this alone, as he is Gastly's trainer and they could grow strong together. Gastly, after a while, looks at Froslass, and Paul tells him that he brought over Froslass just to train him, and Gastly gladly accepts this offer. They train for the entire night and also the day after. As the day after tomorrow, Paul arrives at the entrance of the Cerulean Cave only to find Kadabra meditating. Gastly is charged up with a poisonous aura as it stares down its new rival. They begin their battle once again, and Gastly is faster and stronger this time, connecting with Shadow Ball once from Kadabra. However, the level difference and the skill difference of the two are still really wide. Despite his best efforts, Gastly is unable to do any significant damage on Kadabra as it begins to lose the battle once again. Determined not to fail against the psyche Pokemon and not to disappoint Paul once again, he evolves into Haunter. Now the battle starts to become more and more even. Although Kadabra still has the upper hand, Haunter is continuously adapting to Kadabra's battling style and its high level. Eventually, Kadabra starts to tire out as Haunter finds the opening and connects with his new attack, which Paul had prepared him for, Toxic. This immediately connects on Kadabra, but for some reason Kadabra is not hurt by the poison. Paul figures out that Kadabra has a magic guard ability, which means that he would only take damage from attacks. Kadabra starts to smirk as he fires off another Psy Shock attack, and Haunter fires a Shadow Ball. After this, Haunter disappears into the shadows and connects with a powerful Nightshade. Kadabra is able to hold him at bay using his Confusion attack and try to connect with a Psy Beam. However, Haunter is able to use Double Team and evade the attack. After a while, the both begin to tire out. As a last-ditch effort, Haunter fires a Shadow Ball, Kadabra fires a Psy Shock. The both attacks collide, creating a massive explosion. When the dust settles, Paul finds both of them to be knocked out. Paul takes this opportunity to throw a Pokeball and catch the Kadabra, adding him to his team. Paul later thanks Haunter for an amazing battle and says that he's proud of him and promises him that he would definitely be on his team in his next frontier battle. Haunter is glad and happy to have finally caught up to the level of his rival, but is still upset that Paul included the Kadabra into his party. And guys, that would bring us to the end of this part. This was a relatively short part, and because the next part is already recorded, that is coming soon, so stay tuned for that. And I hope you guys like the concept of Haunter and Kadabra being on Paul's team, because as we know that Paul is the counterpart to Silver, and Silver had Alakazam and Gengar in his team. So that's the direction I'm going, in case you are curious. Anyways, thank you for watching, guys. I hope you liked it. Stay tuned for the next part, and God bless. Thank you.